folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the utmost pleasure of showing off for you the brand new, as of recording this video, Epiphone 1963 SG Custom Joe Bonamassa reissue. Hell yeah! One of my favorite Bonamassa songs right there, and if you know what it is, comment down below. It's kick-ass, almost as kick-ass as this guitar. Of course it's great, it's an Epiphone Bonamassa model. Now, personally, I've loved everything Epiphone and Bonamassa have collabed on because it's the best way to get faithful recreations that are also affordable of guitars that us mere mortals would never even get a chance to look at, let alone feel, or have a piece of wood and metal which share the same familiar attributes and features. Joe's collection is known, well, the Nerdville collection, which says on the case for this guitar, is one of the most impressive, most eclectic, most wonderful guitar collections on the entire planet. And of course, as the name and everything suggests, this is a recreation of his 1963 custom color, ordered not by him, SG Custom. Now, Joe's signature guitars with Epiphone and to an extent Gibson have always been quite interesting because they're not overtly signature. It's not as if he's got his own long-standing guitar, which they're making a replica of, like his version of Eddie's Frankenstrat or Stevie's Number One or like Willie Nelson's Trigger or something. As the name suggests, it's more of a collaboration because, like I said before, Big Joe has one of the most impressive, aggressively jealousy-inducing collections of rare, unique, well-preserved guitars on the entire planet. And the fact he's doing it through Epiphone, like he just every now and then he just picks a few choice ones. Like we've all seen the ones in the past, a few choice ones, and goes, "I'm gonna let the world enjoy this just as much as I do." I think this is quite a rare, unique piece, or a famous piece, let's say, and he recreates it for the world through Epiphone. So it's a lot cheaper than the bloody originals. Let me say that for once. And the attributes and the specs and the features, it's more than just a paint job. There's certain little attributes and stuff which really make these guitars unique and they don't cost hundreds of thousands of pounds. And this Epiphone 1963 SG Custom is exactly that. One of Joe's favorite, most unique variants of a certain guitar that he's sharing with the world and letting us all enjoy and bask in its reflective glory. It's brilliant. So what's unique about this? Everyone knows the SG Custom. I'm a lover and user of SG Customs myself, and I have been for years. And you probably know they come in white, pretty much. The white SG Custom with the three pickups and the Maestro and the ebony board of the blocks and the big old diamond on the headstock, it's just iconic. Back in 1963, someone must have custom ordered Joe's original, which this is a replica of, it in red. He says cherry red in a few videos, but it's wine red. It's like dark wine. I've got another one of my SGs here. That's cherry red. It's a bit darker, isn't it? So like wine red. And the wine red contrasts wonderfully with the gold of an SG Custom. It's just fabulous. So what makes it special is the fact that it was a custom color in 1963 SG Custom. But with it being an SG Custom as opposed to an SG Standard, that also adds to its wonderful, unique, special factors. So with that, let's get into the specs. It rings like a bell, it really does. Love the snap of an SG. The SG is my favorite guitar of all time, more specifically SG Customs, so I'm absolutely living for this review right here. But anyways, let's get into the specs. Got a mahogany construction, as you'd expect, mahogany body and mahogany neck. And one of the first unique features you'll see when you pick this guitar up is the neck joint. So it's actually got a lovely kind of tapered smooth contoured neck joint. Let's take that off there. I mean, you might be able to see a picture on screen right now. So opposed to a traditional SG, it's got a lovely kind of smooth neck joint where the body meets the neck, which is on the original and on the Epiphone reissue. The slim taper C profile on that mahogany neck is also extremely comfortable, as you'd expect. It's a very familiar neck for this kind of guitar and just fits in the palm of your hand. Just lovely. And laden on top of it, of course, is an ebony fingerboard, a trademark of a custom with the block inlays, 22 medium jumbo frets, and it's a 12-inch radius. So very familiar, again, fingerboard for this kind of guitar. Fingerboard is bound as well, but notice up at the headstock, it's also bound, as you can see, but the binding is yellow. It's aged quite yellow, and that's exactly the same on Joe's original. So aesthetically, that matches the same. Usually you see like Les Pauls with the white binding, and this went yellow over time. For some reason on Joe's, the binding on the neck has stayed creamier than the binding on the headstock, and that's been faithfully recreated on this guitar, just as has the waffle back Cluson style tuners up top. And they're quite hard to get a hold of now, apparently, according to Joe, so that's a fun little unique feature on this guitar too. You'll notice as well, it hasn't got Joe's name on the truss rod cover or on the back or anything like that. It doesn't actually say his name anywhere on this guitar. It has got it on the case, though. The case is wonderful, the lovely Bonamassa Nerdville, California case with Fragile written on it. It's an awesome little feature that comes with all of Joe's signature Epiphones. We haven't got his name on the guitar anywhere. Moving back down to the body, more custom SG custom staples, three pickups. It's just absolutely great. I'm a sucker for a three pickup SG, if you couldn't tell. And the way this is wired is pretty interesting compared to regular three pickup SGs. So these are ProBucker 2 in the neck and the middle, and a ProBucker 3 pickup by Epiphone in the bridge. Neck works as a neck pickup, bridge works as a bridge, but in the middle, these two pickups are firing at the same time. But not out of phase, they're actually in phase, which is quite rare for a guitar like this. You rock on the standard configuration of two volumes and two tones, but the bridge volume actually controls the volume of the middle pickup too. And other fun little unique features on this guitar which make it very special is the fact that there's nylon saddles on the Epiphone Locktone Tunematic bridge. Again, it was a staple back in the early 60s to have these. Modern SG Customs don't really have these either, unless it's a special version, so that's a nice little unique touch. Just as it is on Joe's original, you'll find it on the Epiphone. Just as you will, the Maestro Vibrola, which is one of the coolest things in the world. Again, on all my SGs, I've got one of these. What I will say, is that they make the SG turn into the coolest looking guitar on the planet. It's just an iconic look with the SG with the Maestro. However, If you're a bit too heavy-handed with it, your guitar will go out of tune. They're not known for their awesome tuning stability, they're known for looking awesome. And adding a bit of weight to the body, adding a bit of mass to the body, which helps a bit with neck dive and also sustain, if you believe that weight and mass add sustain. But it just looks really cool. So be very sparing when it comes to using this, because your guitar might go out of tune. But it is what it is. I'd take that for this, how amazing this guitar looks. You've got custom at the bottom of the neck right here as well. And I do think that's all the specs. I'm running into a Boss tuner into the Blackstar Saint James 6L6 head. I'm hearing it through the cab, but you guys are hearing it through the Two Notes Torpedo Captor X, which has an impulse response of a Blackstar cabinet. That's enough chatting. I thought I might have to tune after playing with that whammy bar, but no, we're good. This is the Epiphone 1963 Joe Bonamassa Signature SG Custom. So that's just a straight up bridge pickup. Mm-hmm. When you switch to the middle position, you get the middle pickup and the bridge pickup together. Yeah? So you do get a bit more of a kind of squawky tone, but not overtly. Sometimes it kind of sounds a bit like a Strat. And the neck pickup is just so creamy and wonderful with that ProBucker too. Let's hear it with some clean tones there. The bridge pickup is a bit, it sounds a bit lower output. That could just be because it's further away from the strings. I think, ladies and gents, that's all the sight specs and sounds I can give you out of the absolutely wonderful looking, playing and sounding Epiphone Joe Bonamassa 1963 SG Custom reissue. In all of its glory, let me know what you think down below in the comments. I think it's kick-ass, but I want to know what you think as well. And if you want to get one for yourself, there's a link in the description box down below. It'll take you to pmtonline.co.uk. We are playing music today on all social media platforms. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.